Hi everyone, Marine here for Learn Fun. I'm so happy to be back with this super cute apple themed card. We meet the mouse family again. This time they're busy picking apples and selling yummy things that they have baked in their lovely apple house. So let's check out the supplies I'm going to use. I'm going to use the main die, the biggest one from the Peekaboo Pop-Up die set, the outside in-stitched apple die set, and to create the house, we have the door from the Pumpkin House die set, the window, chimney, and doorknob from the Mushroom House die set, the stairs from Build a Castle to Make an Awning, the shutters from the Scalloped Tweetbox Beach House add-on, and the Grassy Hillside die. I picked a bunch of images from Absolutely Awesome and several mice from Berry Special, from You Autumn Know, and from A Creature Was Stirring. I will use the flower boxes from Garden Before and Afters to make tables. And finally some grass from Swan Soirée and from Totally Awesome. So here we have all my stamped images. I stamped them all using Learn Fun Jet Black ink. As always, I stamped more images than I'm going to need, but by doing this, it gives me more options when I assemble the scene at the end. So I'm using my trusty alcohol markers to color everything, and I'm starting with the apple tree. I'm coloring the apples using different shades of red, as well as a touch of green at the top of the apple around the stem. So we're done with the images. I used the coordinating dies to cut them all and set them aside to move on to the background. I cut a panel using the main die from the Peekaboo pop-up die set. And I'm going to use it in a different way, with the score lines at the bottom, to create kind of a pop-up element, and this way extend my card. And I used the same die to cut a smaller piece, and I'm going to use that smaller piece to cut the grass border that will go at the bottom of the panel. And this grass border, I want it to go slightly higher than the lower score line. So I lined up both panels and taped the grass border on the smallest one, right above the lower score line. And I sent it to my die cutting machine. And here we go. Here we can see that the grass border covers the lower score line, so it's perfect. Now I'm going to color the grass border and to apply the inks more easily. And make sure that the grass sprigs don't bend. I'm just going to temporarily tape the border to the second half of paper using washi tape at the back. And I'm going to color it using Modlon and Rustic Wilderness Distress Inks. And then add a little bit of texture to make this element less flat. Now let's color the main panel. The apple tree and apple house will go above the upper score line. So I'm taping my grass stencil a quarter of an inch above that score line. And I'm using the same inks and adding the same texture as the grass border I did before. And we're done with the grass borders. Now we're going to make a simple sky using the cloudy stencil along with tumble glass and salty ocean distressings. I like to apply tumble glass first all along the stencil. And next I add a little bit of salty ocean to bring more contrast. And then I mix the colors using my tumble glass blending tool again. And here's a close-up look at the panel, super cute and bright. Now I'm going to quickly create the apple house. I'm going to color the big apple using my distressings. And for the other pieces, I will use my alcohol markers. I'm coloring the apple the same way I colored the images. I'm adding red shades first on most of the apple, leaving the top white to add a little bit of green. So the apple is all done. Now we have all our elements to finally assemble everything. I white heat embossed my sentiment on the grass border. And I also added vellum at the back of the door and windows. And the first thing I'm going to do is to fold the score lines on the main panel. I'm folding the upper score line to form a valley. And I'm folding the lower score line to form a mountain. Here you can see we have a mountain in the foreground and a valley behind it. I'm going to stick the additional grass border at the bottom of the panel using double-sided tape. And this is how it will look, very nice. Now we can move on and attach all the pieces on that panel. I'm starting with the apple house, and next I will add the apple tree, the mice, and all the bits and pieces to bring life to this little scene. So, a glass of cider for this cute little mouse, and the scene is done. Now let's attach our panel to a card base. This card base measures 5.5 by 4.25 inches, and I'm going to stick it at the back of the panel, right above the score lines. The corners of the panel are rounded, so I'm quickly trimming the card base around those corners. And that's it, this is the final result. I love how the scene is extended and divided in two parts thanks to the section in the foreground. It looks super cute, and I hope that you will give this design a try. Thank you so much for stopping by, and see you next time. Have an amazing day. Bye.